For this, we adopted a method in the previous class, but here we are going to make a material into the magnet by using this phenomenon, magnetic effect of electric current. And the magnet developed in this method is known as electromagnet, So this is electromagnet. What the electromagnet is? Electromagnet is simply a magnet formed by winding the coil over a material and passing electric current through it. It becomes a magnet. That is the electromagnet. This experiment, this activity can also be performed by us. The electromagnet can also be made by us. For this, we need just an iron nail. Let us take an iron nail. Suppose this is an iron nail, right? And we take an insulated copper wire. We are preferring to take the copper wire because through the copper wire the current can flow easily. Means it is a good conductor after silver. Silver is the best conductor. But silver cannot be used in for all the purpose because it is costly. That's why we prefer to use copper. So we take insulated copper wire, a long insulated copper wire. That long insulated copper wire is wound over this iron nail with many turns. Suppose the insulated copper wire is wound in this way with a number of turns. You can make as many turns as possible. And these are the two terminals left, and these two terminals can be connected with a cell or battery. Now see, we are connecting, it is battery along with the switch. It is the switch, right? Now the switch is open, no current flows through it. The iron nail, it is only the magnetic material, right? As soon as we close the switch, what happens? The current flows through the circuit, flows through this insulated copper wire, and this insulated copper wire is wound over this iron nail. As we know that from Oersted experiment, when we pass electric current through this wire, it produces magnetic field. And here also the magnetic field is produced inside the coil. And inside that coil, the iron nail is placed. As we close the switch, the iron nail becomes magnet. Now we say this is the electromagnet. This is the electromagnet. How can we find, how can we check whether it becomes magnet or simply it remains as iron nail? Just to take another material, magnetic material, it may be all pin or any kind of magnetic material, and put that pin, all pin, put that all pin nearer to this iron nail. If it is attracted, then we can say it becomes the magnet. So that is electromagnet. We can say that electromagnet is also a temporary magnet. Why should we say, why can we say this is electromagnet is a temporary magnet? Because as soon as the switch is open, the flow of current is stopped through this wire. Immediately, this material lost all its magnetic property. There are some materials which become magnet when the current passes through this coil. Until the current is flowing, it remains as a magnet. It works as a magnet. As soon as the flow of current is stopped, the switch is opened, immediately it becomes simply an iron nail. Means it lost all its property. Such kind of magnets are known as temporary magnets. The iron nail, here the material become magnet temporarily till the flow of current. When no current flows, it become the normal material. So that is electromagnet. This is how we can make an electromagnet. Here the strength of electromagnet, strength means attracting ability of this magnet, can be changed. Its strength can be increased or decreased. That depends on the factors. The first factor, if we increase more number of cells, here we connected two cells together. If one more cell is added, more current flows through it, the strength become more. So that means the strength of magnet, this electromagnet, can be increased, can be changed by changing the amount of current flows through it. Amount of current flows through it. The second one is, if the amount of current kept constant, then the number of turns made, turns means the windings. If we make for the same length of wire, if the number of turns is more, if we have more windings, then also the strength of magnetic field increases, the strength of magnet also increases. So the number of turns of this wire. And then we can say the nature of material also, because the strength of magnet also depends on nature of material. Nature of material used here. Nature of material. So these are the factors on which the strength of electromagnet depends. Right? And this electromagnet is used for various purposes. It has so many applications. Electromagnet that is used in electric bell. And many, whatever be the appliances which are working on this principle, in that electromagnet is placed. Right? And one more important application of this electromagnet. Let us list out the uses of electromagnet. Uses. The first use, it is used in the electromagnetic lift or crane. It is used in electromagnetic crane. Crane, a device which is used to shift any object from one place to another place. In many of the industries, this kind of devices are used to lift the heavy load, to shift the heavy load from one place to another place. Electromagnetic crane is used. And then, this electromagnet is also used in electric bell. It is used in electric bell. In many other places, example, in school, you could have listened the sound of electric bell. In that, electromagnet is used. And then this electromagnet is also used to separate the magnetic materials from the garbage. To separate the magnetic material. To separate
separate magnetic material. Separate magnetic materials from garbage. Then it is also used in medical field. In the medical field also, nowadays, it is used to remove some iron particles fallen, very small iron particles fallen into the eyes. Suppose, very small iron particles that in the area of the industry, iron industry, that many of the iron particles, very small iron particles are mixed with the air and are able to flow in air, move in air in the form of dust particles. When that iron particles fallen into the eye, sometimes they may not be able to come out from the eye. If it is go into the eye, then it is very difficult to remove it. For that purpose, to remove the iron particles fallen into the eye, electromagnets are used to remove it. In medical field it is used. These are the uses of electromagnets. Right? And other uses are also there for electromagnets. Because of this property. The property means whenever we require the magnet, we pass the electric current, it becomes magnet. If we do not require the magnet, we can switch off the current. Because of this property, the special property, we are using this electromagnet for various purposes. Now we will talk about the electric bell. A simple device. The electric bell, which is working on the principle of magnetic effect of electric current. The electric bell is working on the principle of magnetic effect of electric current. Right? So, here we describe this electric bell, how it is working and how the magnetic effect of electric current is used in this electric bell. Let us draw a simple diagram, a rough sketch of this electric bell. This electric bell consists of an electromagnet. Suppose, this is the electromagnet. This diagram is also drawn in your book. You can go through the book also. These are the two electromagnets. They are fixed on a board and they are connected by a rod. It may be a insulating rod, right? A rod. This rod is used to fix these two electromagnets. And there is a strand-like structure. Right? Nearer to this electromagnets, we put